Welcome back. This morning we're doing a taste test on these butties.
Mm.
They were very nice. The bacon that was on those butties has just been voted the best bacon in New Zealand.
It was beautiful. Now, the man who made these butties was Chef Steve Logan, who was also head judge at the Lesney's 100% New Zealand Bacon Competition.
And the winner was announced yesterday. We will announce the winner again in just a moment and talk to the winner. Steve, 230 different bacons. All of those bacons would have been good bacons. The rubbish ones wouldn't have been in there. How do you pick a winner from, I mean, what are you looking for?
Well, for a start, using New Zealand grown pork is a good start. New Zealand makes the best bacon. New Zealand grown, but what you're looking for is a good ratio of fat to lean. You're looking at a nice balance of the smoke flavour, the salt flavour, the honey flavour, and if the bacon crisps up a little bit, that's very desirable. And also, you don't want to have too much shrinkage in the bacon. You know, it's frustrating when you're cooking a bit of bacon and it shrivels up to nothing or it just steams in the pan.
Well, that's a very good point, but how do you know that's going to happen? Like, if I'm walking in the supermarket or something looking at bacon, is there a way I can tell whether there's going to be shrinkage?
Well, look first if it's got made in New Zealand. I mean, New Zealand grown bacon, that's a very good start, because we're not importing New Zealand bacon, overseas bacon, which is frozen, so it gets watery.
Mm-hmm.
But I think if you have a look at it and it's got a nice dark pink colour and well, I don't really know how you can tell. You have to cook it, to be honest.
That's a problem, isn't it?
Yeah, it is, yeah. But like I say, New Zealand pork bacon is going to be a good start.
Okay, whose is the best bacon in New Zealand?
Hellier's, middle loin style bacon.
Hellier's middle loin style bacon. And as luck would have it, we actually have Todd Heller with us from Christchurch this morning. Todd, congratulations.
Thank you very much.
What makes your bacon so good?
Well, this particular mid-loin bacon that won the award was a result of 6 months' research. We decided that the premium offering in the supermarkets, we thought we could improve it. So we worked on this product. We went from paddock to plate. We talked to the producer on what type of product we required. We wanted a bacon that would do all the things that Steve's just talked about, one of the secrets is that once we cure the bacon, it actually rests for 2 weeks, and then we do other little things to it, which is a commercial sensitive. And
if you told us, you'd have to kill us, right, Todd?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah. So.
Fantastic.
And of course, yes.
Well, given you've got the best bacon in the land, then how would you serve it?
I would. I still like my bacon grilled, and for brunch on Saturday mornings, and I'll have a nice sausage with it, and probably scrambled eggs. So
That sounds very good.
What
was the award, Todd? Did you get a statuette? A statue or something?
Yes, I've actually got the award here.
Fantastic.
And the bacon, if you'd like to see it. So
let's
I'll just lean forward.
Yeah, lean forward,
okay.
And lift it up.
So here's the cup.
Fantastic.
Oh, that's nice.
And that's the product there.
Oh,
can you
lovely.
See that?
Yeah, that's fantastic. Yeah. That is fantastic. Yeah. And we've not only have we seen it, we've eaten it this morning.
And it's beautiful.
Tell you, Todd.
Oh, that's great. Yeah.
It is great.
Yes.
You know your bacon, I can tell that, because I'm a bit of a connoisseur at the other end of bacon, you see. You're a connoisseur at the baking end, I'm a connoisseur at the eating end.
As am I.
As you might be able to see.
Todd, thanks very much, and thanks to Steve as well for joining us this morning.
Yeah, brilliant. And Steve's beautiful. A damn good chef as well,
that
if you
bacon,
don't mind
buddy, best I've ever had.
Yep, so Steve, you can rustle up a couple more for us, I'm sure.
I'm just feeding the team here.
All right, I bet. Well, forget the team. Don't worry about the team. Send some down for me, Pippa and Peter.
Okay.
All right, we are going gardening next on Breakfast to talk growing garlic, onions, shallots and leeks.
Every road.